friends, I am Tejal from Prakriti Institute. Today we are discussing about the cultural heritage of India, sculpture and the architecture. First off point, that one is the ancient Indian town planning, that is consisting Mohenjo-daro, Harappa, Dholavira and Lothal. And Mohenjo-daro, that one is a consisting, there is a construction of a town, roads, drainage system and public baths and public buildings. So that question that is in the you exam, you have to appear that one, explain town planning of ancient India. So ancient Indian town planning, that is acquired, India has acquired expertise in the field of town planning. Many such of towns have found out during the archaeological excavation work. The towns are divided in three sections: fort of ruler, that is known as a citadel; houses of administrative officer situated on the upper part of the town; third, that one is a residence of a common people, which situated on the lower part of the town. So question layout that should be, you can also make a diagram in this way, triangular shape. First of all, citadel, fort for the rulers were constructed on the citadel. Upper part is a safe and protected with houses having two or five rooms. Lower part, houses on the lower part of the town are mainly constructed with the handmade bricks. So first point, India, jo humne pehle hi discuss kar diya ki India has acquired expertise in the field of a town planning. Many such towns have been found out during the archaeological excavation work. Towns were divided in three sections: fort of ruler, that is known as a citadel; houses of administrative officer situated on the upper part of the town; residence of a common people situated on the lower part of the town. For the rulers were constructed on the upper part of the town. Upper part of the town is a safe and protected with the houses having two or five rooms. So that means ki administrative officers, their houses have consisting two or the five rooms. Houses on the lower part of the house, they are mainly constructed with the homemade bricks. Next point, that one is a Mohenjo-daro. Mohenjo-daro, that means a heap of a dates. Among all civilizations, so just like a Egyptian civilization, Maya civilization, Chinese civilization, Indus civilization, among them, Harappa and Mohenjo-daro had the best town planning. Mohenjo-daro, that one is in 1922, archaeologist named Rakhal Das Banerjee and Dayaram Shahani found out remains of the huge town planning during excavation work, which has been carried out under the guidance of a Sir John Marshall and Colonel Mackey in Lakran district, now which is in Pakistan, of Mohenjo-daro. So that's why that is known as a Mohenjo-daro, the heap of dates. In question, you have to explain their features, which are we discussed before. So first feature, that one is a construction of a town, means municipal composition. So construction of a town, from the point of view town planning, Mohenjo-daro is the best. Why? Because houses were built on the high plant to protect them floods and dampness. Second point, houses of a rich people were double storied, having to 5 to 7 rooms, while those poor people were single story, having 2, 3 or 2 rooms. Towns were fortified. Main entrance of the houses reopen on the side lanes, not on the main road. That one is the extraordinary features of the Mohenjo-daro, that main entrance of the houses that open on the side lanes, not on the main roads. And the remains of the storehouse, kitchen, bathroom were found in the every house. And there was a proper arrangement for doors, windows to keep the house airy and ventilated. Next point is the roads. Roads are the main feature of this town planning. The roads were 9.75 meters wide. The small link roads cross the major one at the right angles. Roads were wide enough for a number of vehicles to pass at a time. That means ki wo, jaisa ki aaj ki situation aise ho gayi hai ki roads, they are overcrowded and traffic jam. But in that ancient time, they have a enough spaces wide that there is a number of vehicle can pass at a time. Pits on the roadside suggest that they must have been lap post even. Roads of the town were straight, main roads without any turn. and this is considered to be speciality of ancient time. There were two main roads. In this city, clearly there were two main roads. One was going from north to south and other was going from east to west. So both cross each other at the right angle. So that one is a second feature. Third feature, there is a drainage system. So drainage system is a unique feature of this town planning. Such drainage system was found nowhere except in the island of Crete in Mediterranean Sea. And this system was built to drain dirty water out from the town. So that's why they have a proper drainage system for the out, that is a drainage for the dirty water. Each and every house has a sea spit. And this planned, systematic, efficient drainage system clearly proves that they were very careful about the health and hygiene. So this type of a drainage system that is not seen in the world in the ancient civilization, any of the ancient civilization, you have to that one remember this one for the VSQ one marker, island of the Crete in the Mediterranean Sea, there is a found only that. Fourth point, that one is a public bath. Public bath, that one is a huge bath, was excavated at Mohenjo-daro. There was an arrangement to put fresh water in and dirty water out. And there might have been facility for hot water and small rooms for the changing clothes. These public baths might have been used on festivals and religious ceremonies. So that one is a unique feature for the public baths. Even at the Modera Sun Temple, you can also see that in the structure there is a temple, and before that there is a, in front of the temple there is a kund like a structure where that is known as a huge bath. Even that Mohenjo-daro bath, that is a seal with the natural tar, so that is a no any option for the water seepage. Next, public buildings. The ruins of the two huge buildings have been found at the Mohenjo-daro. These two buildings may be used as a town hall or theater or as an administrative office or as a granary. The barracks of such buildings was also found out. And this must have been used for accommodating the soldiers. So these are the features of the Mohenjo-daro. Now next point is a Harappa. In 1921, under the leadership of Sir John Marshall, colonial Meki, Dayaram Sahni discovered very ancient remains of Indian civilization from the Monte Grime and the Punjab district near Harappa. So the remains of the Indus Valley civilization were found Rapar in Himalaya region, Alamgirpur at Meerut in Uttar Pradesh, Kalibagan in Rajasthan, Lothal at Dholka in Gujarat, Deshalpur, Shikarpur in Kutch, Dholavira, Rangpur near Limbdi in Saurashtra, Srinathgad, Rosedi near Gondar, Kunshi near Morbi and Somnath, etc. So these places we can find out the remains of the Indus Valley civilization. Now about the Harappa, the region of a Saptasindhu river is a region of our Indian culture. And the culture which developed here known as the Indus Valley civilization, which we consider in the first chapter. So its remains were found first of all from the Harappa, and that's why that is known as a Harappan civilization. So why? There is a one marker question, why Indus Valley civilization that is known as a Harappan civilization, that will be answered. Other thing, that is a copper and stone weapons. And many other things were found from this region. That's why it is also known as a copper stone age. So that means Harappan civilization, that is known as a Indus Valley civilization also. Indus Valley civilization also known as a Harappan civilization. And other thing, copper stone age. Town planning of a Harappan civilization is very systematic. And its granaries, forts were remarkable. People of that age were fond of wearing ornaments. And such remains have been found from the this remains. We can also found the ornaments which they had made in the at that time. We can also find out them in the Lothal at the museum. Next point, that one is a Dholavira. So Dholavira, that is located in the Bachau district, Khadirbet village. Dholavira, that one is in the Khadirbet village, that is in the district Bachau near the Bhuj, that one 180 kilometers away from the Bhuj. Khadirbet, that is a vast desert, and in that one is a wetland area. And in that wetland area, there is a remains of the Dhulavira. They are found. State, you have to remember this one. That one is in the one marker. There is a question. Ki the Dhulavira, that one in the where there is a situated to Khadirvet in the Bachau district near the Bhuj. That is a 180 kilometers away from the Bhuj in the state Gujarat. That is also remarkable for the water purification system. And also the water sways. That means ki they have also water purification system. In this way they collected the water, and then after up the sediments of the water, they allow the water to the other tank. So this type of the water purification that is a seen in the at the Dhulavira site. And here in this there is a name, just like a features, that one is not decoded even today. But something that is a like Dhulavira nameplate, like there is a also remain, there is a displayed on the at the site of a Dhulavira. So Dhulavira, a huge systematic ancient town, compared to Harappan civilization, has been found 2 kilometers away from Dhulavira village at the Khadirvet in the vast desert of Bachau Taluka, which is about 140 kilometers away from Bhuj. Archaeological Department of Gujarat surveyed this heap of ruins. After this, officers of the Archaeological Survey of India had undertaken the research work in 1980. Special task of the excavation was carried out under the guidance of Ravindra Singh Bist. Remains of the Dhulavira palaces, main walls of the town were painted with the white color, which we can see also even now today that Kutch, there is a many regional people, otherwise Kutchi people, they have a houses like white color and circular way, that is known as a bunga. Even their embroidery work, there is also reflect the designs, geometrical designs of the this Dhulavira sites remains. Such fortified walls encircling the town suggest a strong security, and this wall is made up of a clay, stone and bricks. Potable water was also available here, as well as a proper system of a water purification. You have to remember this one, Dhulavira, that one is a that is a proper system of a water purification which set up here, which is not made available even to the modern age, because there is a water purification, that one is a necessary. Why? Because that one is a vast desert of Bachau Taluka. Next point is a Lothal, that one is a situated in Gujarat state in Ahmedabad district, Taluka Dholka, near the Bay of Khambhat. Here there is also remains of the Harappan civilization we can find, and that is also here. There is indication of some granaries and also port. So this shows that it will be something that will Lothal, that had been sometime the ancient port of the Harappan civilization. Lothal is situated between two rivers, Bhogao and Sabarmati, in Dholka Taluka of Ahmedabad district. Dholka is a place 80 kilometers away from Bay of Khambhat, from where 3 layers of the human habitat were found. A huge dockyard was constructed to facilitate the ship in the time of a high tides at the lower eastern part of the town, and this is a unique feature of a Lothal. And such dockyard, storage shop, etc. show the proof of export and import. So that means ki there is a huge dockyard that is constructed in this way, that at the time of a high tides, especially that is as to climate of India, that is just like a trade winds that has start duration of June after June words, and there is eastern part, there is lower eastern part, there is यूनिक फीचर क्या है कि वहाँ पे ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा हाई टाइड्स क्रिएट होती है, तो दैट्स व्हाई इजीली शिप कैन एंटर इनटू द पोर्ट. सो दिस सजेस्ट द लोथल माइट बी अ रिच प्रॉस्परस पोर्ट ऑफ इंडिया, एंड दिस इज अ मैटर ऑफ अ ग्रेट प्राइड नॉट ओनली फॉर अ गुजरात बट ऑल्सो फॉर हिस्ट्री ऑफ इंडिया. थैंक यू.